are here on the SCU Europe System Center Universe, and now on my side another MVP for virtual machine. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Daniel Neumann from Germany, and I'm not MVP for virtual machine. Instead, Cloud and Data Center Management, or the full name System Center Cloud and Data Center Management. I think it's the longest MVP name we have in the MVP expertise.
I'm not sure. I think James, who's MVP for the System Center, this is a little bit longer, but I'm not sure. So, your session on the SCU will be?
On Friday morning, I think. I have not the time in mind, but it's about troubleshooting the infrastructure as a service, usage, metering and reporting. It's all from VMM, SCOM, SPF and Windows Azure Pack, and how to troubleshoot a broken metering chain. And it's an addition to Markus Klein, his session on the evening today about the web and the infrastructure as a service, usage metering with Cloud Cruiser and so on.
So on your session you will introduce tools, and will this be only tools from Microsoft or from third-party providers?
It will be only tools from Microsoft, and especially it's only the WAP database who gives us the information how to troubleshoot the issue you are, or the issue that's happened.
So I've talked with other MVPs, and they told me that you can manage different VMs, not only from Microsoft, but also from VMware, the time when you have a hybrid scenario between the migration. Can you also troubleshoot this scenario, so this is different VMs?
That's a problem. I've discussed with some MVP colleagues yesterday that it's not possible to meter VMware VMs or Citrix VMs when they are under the management from the virtual machine manager, because they are not sending the information how long the VMs are running, CPU usage, RAM usage, disk usage. It's all about Hyper-V and VMM, who manages Hyper-V and VMM and the connection to SCOM, and VMM sends the usage metering data to the SCOM data warehouse, where SPF picks it up and transfers to the WAP database. So from my point of view, and as far as I know, it's not possible with VMware VMs or Citrix VMs that I manage with Virtual Machine Manager.
So when you're looking at the troubleshooting tools, what are the most often challenges an administrator are confronted with?
The most challenge is how to identify the issue. What is happening? It is a stopped web service, like Service Provider Foundation or Windows Azure Pack are both web services. And which web service or which application pool has stopped, has issues or authentication issues? That's the main reasons you have in a productive environment with the usage metering. The initial configuration process is another part. Markus will that cover today in his session, and I will give a review. So the attendees who cannot attend Markus' session, I give it a short introduction in my session, so we can move forward to the productive environment and there's the troubleshooting.
So we don't have discussed before we make the interview about my question. So perhaps, I don't know if you have an idea for the next one. If I'm looking at Hyper-V, it has a lot of great functions. And I mean, the customer are really dependent on the IT, and that the IT is running. And this is one of the reasons why they make virtualization, for, in my opinion. So when you look at the troubleshooting things and Hyper-V, what do you think is a great offer Hyper-V makes for the administrator, that if trouble comes in his IT infrastructure, that he can face them and the customer still running his IT?
Okay, yeah, I think it's troubleshooting in the main reason, not especially about the usage metering troubleshooting, and Hyper-V is especially the most awesome tool in the IT, because we have live migration, shared nothing, live migration storage, live migration, so we are able to migrate the virtual machine to another host mm-hmm. to maintain our productivity and also can troubleshoot some Hyper-V hosts, shut them down, change the hardware and so on, and all we can do, and our environment is running and mm-hmm. we do not face any out times to our services we provide to our customers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Troubles are normal in the IT. And it's a complex infrastructure. So thank you, Daniel, for this interview and giving the insights of your sessions.
Thank you, Kerstin. It's a pleasure.
Yeah. Okay.